ADS-B is a new transmission protocol. Or when I say new, it's been around for a couple of years, but it's new in being taken up in South Africa. So it works like a transponder. So transponders respond to radar interrogation from air traffic control. ADS-B is different in that it broadcasts. It doesn't wait for an interrogation signal. It just offers a lot more information where the current legacy system doesn't. So we represent a US-based company called uAvionix, and they've come up with a couple of innovative, easy-to-install, low-cost units. So the mandate that I spoke about is driven by the Civil Aviation Authority, and they've mandated that all aircraft operating in Class A airspace and Class C airspace around certain airports need to be fitted with a Mode S and an ADS-B transponder. What we have here is the tailBeaconX. It actually replaces the tail navigation light. It's got an integrated GPS, so it responds to Mode S interrogation, and it's an ADS-B out. That's connected through to one of the two control heads that we have here. This is the AV30 and the AV20, so you can actually have either one of those. So when you fly into controlled airspace, ATC will give you a squawk code, and you will key in that squawk code, and you'll be squawking then on that code. On this side, we have the SkyEcho. Just like the tailBeaconX, it replaces a wingtip light, but it's an ADS-B in. It receives ADS-B signals, and you can connect to an iPad running an electronic flight bag application, and you can then see air traffic around you coming through into the SkyEcho. And then we have the SkyEcho, which is a portable device. You just stick it onto your windscreen with a suction cap. This is an ADS-B transceiver. So it transmits on ADS-B and it receives on ADS-B. And we actually do transponders for drones as well. So that little device there is a Mode S ADS-B transponder with an integrated barometer and GPS and a GPS antenna. So that will also respond to air traffic control radar interrogations, and it will transmit on ADS-B out.
When does this all come into being?
So the first mandate is slated to kick in on the 12th of June, 2025. So that'll be for operating in Class A. Okay, so Class A airspace is anything between 18,000 feet above sea level and 60,000 feet. So any aircraft operating in that altitude across the country would need a Mode S ADS-B transponder. Class C is in any altitude above 4,000 feet above the location of the airport. So, and then within you have your inner core, which is your 5 nautical miles, and then your outer, which is 10 nautical miles. So 10 nautical miles around an airport at 4,000 feet, you would then need below 4,000 feet, you'd need a Mode S ADS-B transponder. And currently that will only be applicable around OR Tambo International and Cape Town. The rest of the airports in South Africa will be implemented in a phased approach, but that won't happen until 2027.
So I think there's additional safety features that come with something like this. I mean, is detection. Basically,
with ADS-B, because it's broadcast, it's broadcast to everybody. It's not broadcast due to an interrogation. So that means other air users using something like a SkyEcho can now receive those signals, and they can position or see other aircraft in their immediate airspace in relation to themselves. So it gives them a lot more visibility about what's happening around there, which of course adds to that whole air safety aspect that we're all working towards.